We recently spoke with a servant of God who brings the message of Pope Francis to life, who takes the words of our Holy Father and acts on them among a diverse people scattered across a vast geography. Bishop George Thomas from the Mission Diocese of Helena, Montana.
Well, I think the church needs to be living where ordinary people live and to understand the travails and difficulties and challenges ordinary people face, understand the rhythm of family life, struggles and joys. And there's only one way to do that, and that's to live among the people. And it's a great thing about this diocese. It's like one gigantic parish spread out across this vast geographic. It's an area twice the size of Ireland. So we're scattered in the mountain communities, in some of the vast plains. We have 100 communities, half mission communities, half parish communities, some in larger towns. We have university communities. We've got tiny hamlets. We've got mining communities, ranching, recreational, timber. The diversity is immense. Well, I grew up in a mining town called Butte. Both my mom and dad were probably my first and best teachers. And I knew early on that I was being called to the priesthood. In my junior year at Carroll, I went to see the Bishop of Helena. And I said, I think I'm being called to the priesthood. And the rest is history. I graduated from Carroll College, and at age 21, entered seminary and never looked back. Catholic Extension has been a pivotal player in the establishment of our mission communities across this very vast region. If you go to the back of most of our mission churches, you'll see a plaque that memorializes Catholic Extension's role. But they continue beyond the establishment of buildings. They are also investing in people. And so the formation of youth leaders, the formation of young adults, assisting with our seminarians, and in some cases, directly assisting with some of our programs that lift up the poor and the needy. The Good Samaritan Industries was formed many years ago by all the parishes in the Greater Helena area. It's a transformational ministry. People come in need. They come with lives that have sometimes been touched by either addictive disorders or coming out of prison. Needing new opportunities. And the staff at Good Samaritan believes in them.
We follow our teachings. Our Catholic teachings is to serve all people. We have the store, which is a ministry, and we employ people who have come across hard times. Often people tell me they don't feel they're part of society. That doesn't matter here.
The Native people, both at the Blackfeet Nation and in the Salish Kootenai, are among the greatest blessings in my life. They are Catholic people extraordinaire. And obviously there's poverty and there are challenges of every kind there, but the great thing they offer is living life in Christ. When I was first made Bishop of Helena, I went to what we call Indian Days. It's a powwow up in the Blackfeet Nation. And I was so taken aback by the welcome I received from the Blackfeet Nation.
We gave him an Indian name from our tribe, and his Indian name is Holy Warrior. He's just so down to earth, and I think he understands our people. I see a lot of good things in the future because of Father Kohler and Bishop George Thomas.
I see our De La Salle Blackfeet School as one of the brightest lights for our people on the reservation, because it is our future. We're looking for a 12 grade school system is what we're looking forward to. And make Jesus the center of it. That's another part of it. So that's a major thing for us.
Bishop Thomas and Father Ed, they are 100% behind our religious education and are always promoting it. They're trying to get more people involved, trying to do more things for our youth. I think they're so awesome because of their devotion to our youth.
Thy gifts which we're about to receive from thy bounty through Christ our Lord.
St. John Baptist de La Salle,
pray for us.
There's a mountain range outside of Helena that looks like a sleeping giant. So Bishop Thomas, at this coffee night, he gestured to us, the college students, and he said, I want to awaken the sleeping giant. And I've always remembered that moment. And I know that it lit a spark in my own heart.
Every bishop knows how important the youth are, but not every bishop has the gifts to reach the hearts of the youth. And Bishop Thomas does.
If you go around to the youth, they know him and he knows them. You know, like the shepherd knows the sheep and the sheep know the shepherd.
I think the fact that they can like take a selfie with the bishop and like tell the bishop a joke and take like a big youth group photo with the bishop is like the coolest thing ever. And I think they think that's awesome, and it brings the church a little closer to them.
He's present in a way that allows them both to be themselves but also to rise higher and become the people that Christ has called them to be. So this retreat for us takes place in a great location called Legendary Lodge, which is owned by the Diocese of Helena. And because Carol is a diocesan college, we're blessed with the opportunity to come up here with a class.
Legendary Lodge is built around a vision of what John Paul called encuentro theology, encountering Jesus Christ deeply and personally. And young people come to the lodge sometimes knowing intellectually about the Lord, but it's a place where they meet him. And it happens magically, wonderfully, year after year. The mountain climbing, Eucharist at the top of the mountain, the different water sports that they are able to do there. And this is a unique setting. It's Montana at its best.
My job is reaching out to young people at a time when they're making huge decisions about who they want to be, what is important to them, how they want to live their life, and what their purpose or vocation is. I've taken with me a lot of amazing experiences with the youth around me. I'm taking a very powerful prayer life that has grown over the course of my years in ministry, and I'm taking a desire to serve.
The Diocese of Helena currently has 15 seminarians. We have 9 who have Carol roots. And that is profound for us, because Carol College was founded, Bishop Carol's vision for the college was to provide a local clergy for the people of Montana. And we're seeing that happen once again.
I think it's awakening a sleeping giant in this church. And there are hundreds and hundreds waiting to be invited to be activated in the life of the church.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
He's a personal bishop. That's what makes him special.
He's here to make sure we follow Catholic teachings, social justice for all people.
He's just a good man who really loves people. He loves the Lord, he loves the church, but he meets people where they are.
You could tell he loves us. That's what matters.
And we trust him, you know, he's looking out for us.
I quoted St. Augustine, and he says in just very few words what I believe so strongly in. He said, if you look deeply enough into the eyes of any person, there you will see something that is divine. And I think that summarizes the heart of Catholic social teaching, Catholic social outreach, and our ministry to the poor, that every person is made in God's image. Every person has inherent value, and part of our mission is to help our brothers and sisters recognize Christ in every face that they see. So I think it's a transforming ministry, a transformational ministry, and I think the poor help us see that very well. Our hearts are restless until they rest in Thee, O Lord.
Bishop Thomas's ministry works both on a very personal level and on a broader level as the leader of his diocese, moving people to a life in Christ and moving the church forward.